There was a question that if we have a pirated software, working in a place which has pirated software, is it haram? Is it halal? What is the view? So, you know, this piracy of the software, I've given a talk on that. It's a long answer, more than half an hour, talking about the piracy. The various aspects of look into it. One thing is there are many softwares which are produced in the world. They're very expensive. Normally, piracy per se is haram, general. But there are some software which many of the companies, they themselves introduce piracy so that it becomes famous. But all the people who are small companies, they buy pirated version for 100 rupees, 200 rupees, 500 rupees, it becomes popular. But the big companies can't afford, because if there is a suit filed against them, they get a problem. So they purposely make the software popular by creating piracy themselves, making it popular, and those top companies, they buy the version which is expensive, 100,000 rupees, 200,000 rupees, or 50,000 rupees. So now, if the piracy has been encouraged by the company itself, and if you're using that software, I feel Islamically there's no problem. If the company hasn't encouraged and using it, then it is wrong. So all this, the various aspects to it, but there's a difference between, are you talking about Islamic software, or are you talking about general software? If you're talking about Islamic software, the ruling is different, pros and cons are there. If you're using general software, like Microsoft or Windows, etc., so the thing is, this becomes a gray area. It's a gray area. But one more thing. There are some companies which say, fine, you buy one, second one you pirate, no problem, they're not object. So even the boss comes to know. Normally when you go, the software is expensive, 100,000 rupees, 200,000 rupees. $5,000, $10,000. You buy software. And they say, fine, you have got three computers, buy one, remaining you copy, no problem. So the company also knows about that, indirectly, not in writing, but verbally they're agreeing. And then if you use such a software, there's no problem. Or suppose you have 10 computers, 10 computers, kam az kam do to kharido. So buy two, and the remaining, it is a gray area. Generally, piracy per se is haram. If you ask me in yes or no, piracy is haram. Generally, if you ask me, is piracy of software allowed or not? One word answer, it is haram. But then depending upon the way the company functions, then they have educational version of it. So various loopholes they have given. So if you know that you are within the purview, and then if you use and you buy a software from official vendor, it tells you fine that you can use one pirating, you do, etc. But generally only using pirate software per se is haram. And you are working in that company, see, you as a worker, you can tell the boss, see, this is pirated. So you as a worker working in a company, they are using pirated copies, you don't fall directly in that aspect of creating a sin. Because you have told him, if he tells you it is not pirated, you won't come to know whether it's pirated or not. Fine? So you as a boss, the problem is different, the question is different. But you as working in the company, if the boss provides you something, you are doing your job, you are working, so directly you won't be held responsible for that. Hope that answers the question. You had some question, brother? What about Islamic software? Now, brother wants to know about the Islamic software. Now, coming to the Islamic software, again, the purpose is important. The purpose of the Islamic software, suppose a company has created a software of the Quran, of the Hadith, and spent a lot of money. And then, if that software is available in that country, in that city, and for you to save the money, instead of paying 5,000 rupees, you want to buy 200 rupees, then it is haram. But if that software is not available, if it is a software created abroad, and no one in Bombay has, one person has, and your intention is not to save money, your intention is to use it for knowledge and spread it, then it's fine. But then if you take that software and make a copy and sell, it is haram. The selling person is surely haram. If you make a copy and give it free to your friend, it may come in the gray area, no problem. But see to it that unnecessary should not got damage to the main person who has produced that software. So if you're living in a country where software is easily available, and then if you pirate it to save money, it is wrong. But if you're living in one part of the world where the software is not available and you want to have knowledge of the Quran, want to search the Quran, want to study the Quran or Islam, etc., and then because of lack of availability, if you make a copy, inshallah, inshallah, Allah will forgive. But if you make it as a business, make copy and sell, then it is wrong. You can directly tell to the company, see so and so thing is there, I want to make copy and sell, give me permission. With permission, no problem. Hope that's the question.